folks. Good evening. Great to have you here with us. I'm Cliff LeCain from the Q, and I really enjoyed being the announcer at West Hills last season. We're looking forward to another great season, an approved season with PFC. Great to see you all here tonight. We're very excited. We're here today at the beginning of PFC's second season in the Canadian Premier League. The owners of Pacific FC are here with us this evening, Rob Friend and Josh Simpson. Boys, where are you? Say hello. I'd like to introduce Pacific FC's new head coach, Pa Madu Ka. Pa, where are you? Great to see you here. Goalkeeper coach, Mark Village. Mark. And associate head coach, James Merriman. James. The season kicks off almost here, folks. April 11th, West Hill Stadium. I'm telling you, that is a great place to watch a football game. You play on a pitch. I'm learning all the terms, but it's a fantastic place to watch a game. The officials with PFC and, of course, the city of Langford have done amazing things out there, and we're looking forward to even bigger crowds in the upcoming season, and what is one of the best facilities as far as the fans are concerned in the entire league, because we are right on top of the play. And by the way, I know many of you are season ticket holders, obviously. The support last season was just amazing. We have some great fans in the city. We look forward to seeing you out there again. PFC has been very busy in the offseason. The indoor training center that is powered by Pacific was completed and opened in December. It's an amazing facility. If you haven't seen it, this is a 55,000 square foot facility. It's the official training center of Pacific FC. It also has soccer and other sports for kids and adults of all ages. It is truly a community facility, and it will be well used, so it's a great facility. The ITC housing the Trident Development Program for keen young soccer players. And next month, there will be kids out there in spring break camps. The next players for PFC are being developed at that facility. And in case you haven't already heard it, this weekend we're having an exciting event at the ITC. It's a big one, folks. Please check this out. Are there any gamers? There's got to be some gamers here. This Saturday at the ITC, you can win and qualify to be the EA Sports FIFA Champion of Canada and win $10,000. You can register for this weekend's big event online, and your chance to get some tickets to Toronto for the CPL finals on May 9th. Where do we register for this, for the event? Do we have a website that we can go to, or?
Yes.
Yes. I knew you would know. I should have gone right to you. Because years ago, didn't you attend Belmont?
I did.
Yes. Are you proud of that?
Say yes.
I was, you know, Josh, I was at Belmont before they had what is known as indoor plumbing. So I go back a ways, right? So you were there. Yeah, okay. This is open to players 16 years and older, so please check it out. It's a big event. One of the main reasons why we're here, first of all, a chance to say hello to everybody, is we're here to unveil, and this is exciting, the home jerseys for the upcoming season. Josh, we don't call it a unit, we call it a kit?
Yes.
Okay. The home kit. I like that. That's fantastic. We're going to unveil a home kit tonight. Huddled the back of the fan shop, we have seven of PFC's finest players. They're all wearing the Pacific FC jerseys and are looking forward to making their modeling debut to show them off. Is that them back there? Modeling debut, boys, to show them off. Now, please put your hands together for our first player and model. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome, with over 250 professional appearances, Haley from Newmarket, Ontario, leading the team out as our captain and leader on and off the pitch, defender Marcel DeYoung. Oh, wow. Marcel, do another walk. Come on, this is your bodily debut. Okay. This is the best part of the script for me because I get to talk about what you're wearing. You can stop walking if you want. Okay. Now you can see the jersey maintains. Come on back here. Oh, please come back here. I'm ordering him around. Isn't this great? It maintains the primary color. Starfish purple, all right? This is inspired by Vancouver Island's sunset. Oh, I like that. The fade design, you can check that out, from purple to white, is the association between the Pacific sunset and the crash, I love this, and the crashing wave on the shore. Are you pretty inspired by this? I am, I like it. It's a great looking jersey. The creative stripe design is inspired by the island's starfish. Poseidon's trident, you can spin around, just spin around a little bit. Poseidon's trident is showcased on the back of the jersey. Spin around. As a symbol to, this is the best part, to control the game and protect the island. I like that. That's good. Like, you want to stay here? Or you, well, yeah, you're done for now, but you. Where are you going to go? You've had enough of this, haven't you? They're going to sit, okay. Moving on, our next player and model. Standing at 6'2", a key defender back for the 2020 season. Please welcome center back, Lucas McNaughton. Lucas, come back here. Have you ever done any modeling before?
A couple times.
That's probably the strangest question you've ever had in your career. Okay, thank you. And now we have the first of four of our players to have been called up for Canada's Olympic Provisional U23 squad. Hailing from beautiful Burnaby. He is our inaugural signing. Please welcome defender Caden Chung. I think Caden really likes this. Caden, one more spin. Come on, you love this. No, get back up on the runway here. That's a Caden Chung, one more time. There he goes. All right, folks, one of our new signings for 2020. He decided to sign with the right team this year, wearing the right colors. A veteran of the league with 7 goals, hailing from Winnipeg. Please welcome winger Marco Bustos. Well, Marco, come back here. Come back here. You have to love Victoria in February, don't you?
I love it.
And we're looking forward to a lot of goals from you this season. Again, you made the right choice to come here. You're really going to enjoy the season in Langford and playing here in the island for PFC. Welcome to Victoria. It's great to see you. With over 56 appearances, across the top tier of Mexican soccer with renowned clubs such as CF America and Atlas. Please welcome our latest international signing from Mexico City, number 9, Alejandro El Güero Diaz. Welcome to Victoria, it's great to see you. Another player called up to Canada's Olympic qualifying team, hailing from Burnaby, known as the Canadian Hulk. I didn't write the script, but I love it. The Canadian Hulk. And prolific scoring record in 2019. Please welcome fan favorite and big time scorer, Taryn Campbell. Come on out, Taryn. Taryn, nobody wants to talk to me. I'm used to that. That's okay. Did you think I said Canadian Hulk or Hulk?
Hulk.
Okay. Good answer. Is that the first time you've heard that nickname, or has it been around for a while?
I've heard it a couple of times. I didn't give it myself, but I'll take it.
Well, why not? We're looking forward to another great season from you. Thanks a lot for being here today. Well known across this great island, a winger that scored more than once from a free kick with 6 goals in the 2019 season, hailing from the coast of Spain, winger Victor Blasco.
Enjoying it.
Is that a fake accent, by the way? Because I like it a lot.
It's a reason.
You know, this is the team in the offseason. Ownership has put together a quality group of players. You must be so excited about it.
I'm very excited, yes. I think it's going to be a really good season, you know, and yeah, looking forward to start and happy to see all our amazing fans.
They were amazing last season. We expect to see more out this season. Thanks a lot. Good seeing you here tonight. Victor Blasco. Okay, boys, come back out. There you have it. The new jersey worn by 7 of our PFC players who will take the field April 11th at West Hill. Come on, stand up, boys. Great to see you. Round of applause for our players and models. Okay, am I getting the hook here or what? Okay, getting nervous. You want to say something or you sure? Like, you anytime you want the mic, I'll give it up. Question and answer segment. If you have questions for our players, our new coach, the ownership group, go ahead. I have the mic here. If you have any questions for anybody here? Anybody? You may. I'll bring the mic to you. What's your name?
Adam.
Adam? Good to see you here, Adam. Fire away, buddy.
This is for Taryn and Caden. What's it feel like? I mean, there's a long way to go, but to be called up to the preliminary roster for the Olympic qualifying. It's huge.
I mean, it's always an honor to get called up from your country. It's very exciting, but there's still work to do. We haven't made the qualifiers yet, obviously. But the notice that the young players in this league, specifically for this team, has been pretty amazing. So we're excited and obviously very honored.
Anybody else? TV guy? No, never. I know you got a lot. Yeah, you talk for a little, can relate to that.
Well, I actually do have a question.
You have a question? I'm going to get right to you next, okay? Okay, TV guy.
Just for Marcel, I just want to know, you know, how the summer went, how the off season went, and how are you feeling? How's the leg?
Good question. I'll bring the mic to you. Who is it for again?
It's Marcel.
Okay. It's an age factor, TV guy.
Yeah, first of all, summer was not so good. But no, I'm happy that everything is back to normal, pretty much. And yeah, leg feels really good. Excited, and can't wait to get finally be out there with the guys on the field and play in front of you, all you guys.
I'll try to do my best for every single game I can. I'll put in the work. Every single time I step on the field at West Hills or far away, I'll put in my heart and play for the crest. I'll do my best.
Victor, how many free kick goals?
Two.
No.
Two.
Yes.
No, that was last season. I'm talking about last season. They're going to go for more this year.
Last season, yes, two.
We'll get four or five this year, all right? Let's go for it. Anybody else?
Well, you have to ask Bustos, too, how many he's going to score.
Just say as many as you can get. That's fine.
I'm not going to give a number, but, you know, I want you guys to know that I'm excited to be here. And I'm going to give my all on the field, and whatever I can do for the team to bring 3 points at the end of a game, that's what it's about, right? So let's go.
Yeah, that's a good point. You're going to love playing at West Hills. The fans here on the island are amazing. You're really going to enjoy it. And where we, like I say, we expect more to come out this coming season. You know, we often say that Greater Victoria is not a sports area. That's not true. We have some great sports fans here. Rob, I'm going to ask you a question. I'm getting the stare again. You intimidate me, you know that. Go away, Cliff. It's been quite an off season for you, hasn't it?
Yeah, no, it's been, I'll grab that. It's been a long off season. Actually, the first off season that I guess this club's experienced. But we're obviously excited about the squad we built. We saw what we had last year. And ultimately, it wasn't good enough. And so we looked at where the gaps were, and we filled those with some outstanding players and building on the players that we have. So it's been a long off season, and we're ready to see these guys hit the field. Obviously, Pa's chomping at the bit, and ready to see them start kicking the ball around. And we're excited. It's a talented squad, and it's going to be exciting to watch.
Pa, step forward. Well, I'd love for you to say a few words here. What drew you to the island to coach this squad?
Well, it's simple. The island has a football culture, and also I've been fortunate to play against Rob during my career, and I got to know Josh. But I mean, you know, to be part of something unique that they want to build, that's one of the biggest things for me, you know, joining that club that is motivated, want to give young players their chance. You know, it's a new Canadian league, but, you know, they're very determined to make sure that the young players that we have, Canadian players and also foreign players that have quality and decided to come to this island and show that we can actually bring a quality football team on the pitch. And obviously we know it's a long season, but we'll do our best.
Thank you. Welcome. Josh. Again, quite the off season. Again, obviously, this is a league full of young players, and you have a fairly young roster again.
Yes. In short, absolutely. The goal with Pacific Football Club was to bring opportunity and to change the future of football. 2026 is right around the corner, and so we did not want to invest in the, let's say, the older generation in football, 25 plus. We wanted to spend the majority of our focus younger, ones that would really impact that 2026 squad. So if you look at what we got here, other than being extremely good looking, there's a lot of talent and a lot of youth, which is essentially one-to-one with what our focus is.
You guys must be pleased with the way they've changed the alignment. Then three teams make the postseason, right?
Yeah, no, it's exciting. The playoff system, there was a lot of discussion around that. I think it was a bit confusing last year with the spring and fall. I didn't even understand it half the time. I didn't know if we were in it, if we had a chance. So obviously this is clean, this is simple. You got to make top three for playoffs. Semifinals, home and away, one game final, done. So so it really keeps a lot of the teams in the hunt to get into that top three goal, and then obviously in playoffs anything's possible. So, and then obviously adding that eighth team with Atletico Ottawa, as everybody has seen, the schedule is very balanced. So, that helps for us and the players and the travel. A much more balanced schedule. You're going to see less Wednesday games, which is obviously huge. And so overall, it's just really exciting this season by obviously adding the quality team like Atletico Madrid into this league and the playoff system, the balanced schedule. We're looking forward to it.
Yes, for sure. Both you and Josh obviously played at a high level around the world, a great deal of success in professional soccer, professional football. But the point is that I really believe that what you've tried to build here in a way is a reflection for how both of you played the game. Is that a fair way to look at it?
Yeah, no, absolutely. I mean, when Josh and I set out for this, and we were roommates for 14 years with the Canadian national team, and we didn't make it as professionals as pure talent. It was hard work, and we really translated that into the business side of the sport and building a club with that sort of culture, with those sort of values, right? Hard work, honest work, and we expect that out of our players. And eventually that gets you results. So this is a long-term project for sure. Obviously, as people have seen what we're doing, and having four players getting called to the national team is a testament to what this club's about. But we want to also see results on the field as well. So looking forward to that.
We're looking forward to the season. You're both obviously very good negotiators because you brought in some great talent this year. We're looking forward to see it on the field. Thank you so much for being here, folks. Any more questions before we bail on this portion of anything else? Anybody? Anybody?
I got a question.
Yes.
I got a question for Coach.
Yes.
Just because I'm a defender, that's why you asked that question? I used to play a striker before, so. Well, for me, I love football. And I have a simple answer to that. If the opposition score one, we have to score two.
I like you, that's the way to be. Although when you are speaking to the media, we'd like at least 25 seconds, but that's okay. Where's TV guy? You would know that. He leave? 25 second clips, right? Okay. Abdu. Oh, Semenke. Welcome. I'll let you give the background on your history then in soccer. It's going to take all night? No, it won't. Just the recent years.
Yeah, so I was previously playing at the University of Michigan. In the NCAA, so I think that was a great experience for me to learn as a player. Prior to that, I was in Montreal with the Montreal Impact Academy. So I think both of these experiences have set me up now to be at a place where I'm comfortable at the professional level and where I feel like I can help a team. So looking forward to that.
So here's where I'm testing my knowledge here. I should know this. I'm gonna take, it's not a guess, it's a keeper. Right, you're a keeper, right? Damn, I knew it. Is there not somebody else from Michigan that's in goal, or what? Did I not see that? Must have been a different team. So what position do you play then?
Center back. I'm a center back.
You could play goal if you had to, right? Welcome. So how long, your 4 years at Michigan?
Yes, 3 and a half, yeah.
So that makes you a Spartan?
Wolverine.
Oh. At least I didn't say the Ohio State Buckeyes, did I? No. Anybody else? Any more questions? So we have some jerseys for the folks here today, or? Yes? Was that part of, yes? That's a yes, right? So how are we gonna do that? Okay. Okay, I'd just like to say I'm honored to be here to MC this event. Thanks, guys, for asking me out tonight. I look forward to seeing everybody at the stadium at West Hills. I would just like to say that, you know, you guys are both here, that your idea was to run a professional team because it is a professional team, and you have done it the right way. It is very professional, and good luck to you in the upcoming season. I'm looking forward to all these players, as well as the non-goalkeeper. coming out to play this season. It's so good to see you. Our great, amazing fans. Be loud and proud. Go PFC! Thank you.